Senate will come to order. I ask everyone present to please rise and recite the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
In the absence of clergy, let us bow our heads in a moment of silent reflection or prayer. Reading of the journal.
In Senate, Sunday, May 23rd, 2021, the Senate met pursuant to adjournment. The journal of Saturday, May 22nd, 2021, was read and approved. On motion, the Senate adjourned.
Without objection, the journal stands approved as read. Presentations of positions, messages from the Assembly. The Secretary will read.
Senator Hoylman moved to discharge from the Committee on Codes, Assembly Bill number 4319, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 689, third reading calendar 101.
Substitution so ordered.
Senator Kaminsky moved to discharge from the Committee on Environmental Conservation, Assembly Bill number 7290, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 3321A, third reading calendar 338.
Substitution so ordered.
Senator Kennedy moves to discharge from the Committee on Transportation, Assembly Bill number 6155A, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 5060A, third reading calendar 639.
Substitution so ordered.
Senator Kennedy moves to discharge from the Committee on Corporations, Authorities, and Commissions, Assembly Bill number 6158A, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 6003A, third reading calendar 701.
Substitution so ordered.
Senator Rivera moves to discharge from the Committee on Finance, Assembly Bill number 4572, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 4316, third reading calendar 722.
Substitution so ordered.
Senator May moves to discharge from the Committee on Environmental Conservation, Assembly Bill number 5605, and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 6334, third reading calendar 983.
Substitution so ordered. Messages from the Governor. Reports of standing committees. Reports of select committees, communications and reports from state officers, motions and resolutions. Senator Gianaris.
Good afternoon, Madam President. Amendments are offered to the following third reading calendar bills. By Senator Dabo, calendar 87, by Senator Sanders, calendar 216, Senator Brook, calendar 378, Senator Krueger, calendar 454, Senator Benjamin, calendar 544, Senator Kavanaugh, calendar 707, Senator Brooks, calendar 752, Senator May, calendar 804, Senator Mannion, calendar 810, Senator Brooks, calendar 942, Senator Krueger, calendar 1014, Senator Kaminsky, calendar 775, Senator Harkin, calendar 682, Senator Kaminsky, calendar 978, and Senator Brooks, calendar 758.
The amendments are received and the bill shall retain its place on the third reading calendar. Senator Gianaris.
I also wish to call up the following bills which are recalled from the Assembly and are now at the desk. Senate bill numbers 1172, 2884, 113, 1780B, 5753, 133, 5434, 6293, 1353, 13, 14, 5066, and 4670.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 107, Senate Print 1172 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the public health law. Calendar number 199, Senate Print 2884 by Senator May, an act to amend the executive law. Calendar number 317, Senate Print 113 by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the business corporations law and the limited liability company law. Calendar number 458, Senate Print 1780B by Senator Skoupis, an act to amend the executive law. Calendar number 806, Senate Print 5753 by Senator Ryan, an act to amend the education law. Calendar number 769, Senate Print 133 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the general business law. Calendar number 844, Senate Print 5434 by Senator Harkin, an act to amend the mental hygiene law. Calendar number 888, Senate Print 6293 by Senator Mannion, an act to amend the mental hygiene law. Calendar number 112, Senate Print 1353 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the public housing law. Calendar number 311, Senate Print 13 by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the penal law. Calendar number 312, Senate Print 14 by Senator Holman, an act to amend the penal law. Calendar number 441, Senate Print 5066 by Senator Harkin, an act to amend the mental hygiene law. And calendar number 521, Senate Print 4670 by Senator Parker, an act to amend the tax law.
The vote by which all these bills are passed.
The Secretary will call the roll on reconsideration.
Addabbo, Gianaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White, ayes 60.
The bills will be restored to their places on the third reading calendar.
Offer the following amendments to the aforementioned bills.
The amendments are received.
Can you please recognize Senator Lanza?
Senator Lanza.
Madam President, on behalf of Senator Boyle, on page 66, I offer the following amendments to calendar number 1024, Senate print number 6188, and ask that said bill retain its place on the third reading calendar.
The amendment is received, and the bill shall retain its place on a third reading calendar.
Thank you.
Senator Gianaris.
At this time, Madam President, let's take up previously adopted Resolution 854 by Senator Serrano. Read that resolution's title and recognize Senator Serrano on the resolution.
The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 854 by Senator Serrano, mourning the death of former Assemblymember and Bronx Deputy Borough President Aurelia Green, renowned public servant and devoted member of her community.
Senator Serrano on the resolution.
Thank you very much, Madam President. It's such a pleasure to be here with you. And to pay honor and memorialize such a tremendous leader for the Bronx and throughout the state of New York. Former Assemblymember and Bronx Deputy Borough President Aurelia Green, she passed away recently on Saturday, May 8th, at the age of 86. And I would like to express my sincere condolences to her family and loved ones. She was born in the Bronx, and she dedicated her life to community service. In 1982, she was elected to the New York State Assembly, and she served with distinction for 27 years, becoming the first African-American Speaker Pro Tem for the New York State Assembly. In 2009, she left the Assembly to serve as Deputy Borough President under Ruben Diaz Jr., and she has been to so many of us a mentor, a friend, someone with tremendous kindness and grace. And she was a true pillar of leadership in our community, always with a ready smile, with good advice, and there to help others. And those of us who are in elected office in the Bronx, we owe her such a tremendous debt of gratitude, and we stand on the shoulders of such a great individual. And she did truly dedicate all of her life to the betterment of her community, to ensuring that seniors and children had access to the resources that they need. And she was also one of the most effective and truest coalition builders that I've ever seen before. And at a time like today, where we often find ourselves so stratified, it's so refreshing to have known someone who really found common ground on so many important issues and was able to build upon that for the betterment of our society. So it's with a very heavy heart that I'm here today to memorialize such a dear friend of myself and of my father, who recently retired from Congress, Jose Serrano, and we all here to offer our gratitude and our sincerest condolences to her family. And I'm grateful to all of my colleagues in government here in this chamber for supporting this resolution. Thank you, Madam President.
The resolution was previously adopted on May 20th. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President. Now let's move to previously adopted Resolution 181 by Senator Hinchey. Read that resolution's title and recognize Senator Hinchey.
The Secretary will read.
Senate Resolution 181 by Senator Hinchey, memorializing Governor Andrew M. Cuomo to proclaim May 2021 as Lyme Disease Awareness Month in the state of New York.
Senator Hinchey on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. I rise today to sponsor a resolution proclaiming the month of May as Lyme Disease Awareness Month here in New York. We are so profoundly lucky to have such a beautiful host of natural resources and so many incredible outdoor activities. But with that comes the real danger of Lyme disease and tick-borne illnesses. If you live in upstate New York or really anywhere across the state, we all know someone who has been touched by Lyme disease and has had their lives changed dramatically forever. This is something that we need to raise more awareness for, especially as we have more and more people discovering our incredible outdoor areas and our natural resources. As we have more in-state tourism and more people coming to our outdoor areas, we have to make sure that we keep each other safe and we keep ourselves safe. A real danger with Lyme disease is that an average of nearly 500,000 Americans is estimated to have received a diagnosis of Lyme disease each year from 2010 to 2018. That's a huge number, and I believe only growing. And so I'm incredibly proud today to stand here to raise awareness so that we can keep more and more people safe across New York. And I thank this body and this House for letting this resolution come to the floor. Thank you.
Thank you. Senator Serino on the resolution.
Thank you, Madam President. And thank you, Senator Hinchey, for bringing this resolution to the floor today. The more champions that we have committed to tackling ticks, the better for all New Yorkers. Since I first brought this resolution to the floor, it was 5 years ago, awareness for Lyme and tick-borne diseases has risen tremendously. And I'm sure we can all agree. We see it in our interactions. We see it on social media, TV. We see it even in the press. And it's really been fantastic to see how far we've come. But I attended an event recently that reminded me of just how far we still need to go to better protect New Yorkers and to fund research initiatives that would help improve testing and treatment options for thousands that have been impacted. So the event I went to was called Lift for Lyme, and it was at a local gym. It was about a young man. He was a husband and a father who died by suicide this February after living with a neurological Lyme. And his wife is a licensed clinical social worker. She was not familiar, as were a lot of other people that are in the mental health field, with neurological Lyme. He was diagnosed in November of 2019, and by February 2020, he had to take a leave from work. He couldn't remember how to drive to his job. He couldn't verbalize words that he was thinking in his mind. So by February of 2021, he decided to take his life, and he died by suicide, sadly. So to hear stories like this just absolutely breaks your heart. And there's so much of a disconnect still that we really need the money for research and education and, like I said, testing and treatment. So May is Lyme Disease Awareness Month, but it's also Mental Health Awareness Month. And many may not even know that this connection exists, as I just talked about. We have a duty to ensure that no family has to suffer this way this family has. And that starts by ensuring that our state is leading the way when it comes to the funding for research, education, and prevention initiatives. For too long now, Lyme and tick-borne disease has taken a backseat to other priorities. As we work to rebuild and recover from the COVID-19 pandemic, there hasn't never been a more perfect time to give Lyme the attention that it truly deserves. And when you think about this too, the symptoms that are associated with COVID and those associated with Lyme and tick-borne diseases are incredibly similar. And with New Yorkers taking to the outdoors like never before, we cannot afford to take any steps back in this fight. So while May may be the official Lyme Disease Awareness Month, I hope all of us will redouble our efforts and do everything we can to raise awareness, not just today, but every day. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you. The resolution was previously adopted on January 20th. Senator Gianaris.
At the request of the sponsors, these resolutions are open for co-sponsorship.
The resolutions are open for co-sponsorship. Should you choose not to be a co-sponsor of the resolutions, please notify the desk. Senator Gianaris.
There will now be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
There will be an immediate meeting of the Rules Committee in room 332.
Senate stands at ease.
The Senate stands at ease. The Senate will return to order. Senator Gianaris.
Madam President, there's a report of the Rules Committee at the desk. Can we take that up, please?
The Secretary will read.
Senator Stuart Cousins from the Committee on Rules reports the following bills. Senate Print 293 by Senator Myrie, an act to amend the tax law. Senate Print 396 by Senator Oberacker, an act related to legalizing, validating, ratifying, and confirming a transportation contract. Senate Print 448 by Senator Hoyman, an act to amend the executive law. Senate Print 1275 by Senator Krueger, an act to amend the business corporation law. Senate Print 1761C by Senator Cooney, an act to amend Chapter 416 of the laws of 2007. Senate Print 1810 by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the town law. Senate Print 2193 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the public housing law. Senate Print 2201 by Senator Sepulveda, an act to repeal Subdivision 9 of Section 201 of the correction law. Senate Print 2205 by Senator Addabbo, an act to amend the environmental conservation law. Senate Print 2689 by Senator Martucci, an act to amend Chapter 262 of the laws of 2005. Senate Print 2700 by Senator Ort, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law. Senate Print 2789 by Senator Sepulveda, an act to amend the executive law. Senate Print 2811A by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the executive law. Senate Print 3009 by Senator Sepulveda, an act to amend the general business law. Senate Print 3594 by Senator Gallivan, an act granting retroactive membership in the New York State and local employees' retirement system. Senate Print 3694 by Senator Felder, an act to amend the Administrative Code of the City of New York. Senate Print 4117 by Senator Akshar, an act to authorize the Village of Endicott to offer an optional 20-year retirement plan. Senate Print 4231 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the executive law. Senate Print 86 by Senator Hellman, an act granting retroactive membership in the New York State and local employee retirement system. Senate Print 5399 by Senator Ort, an act to amend the highway law. Senate Print 5419 by Senator Brisport, an act to amend the social services law. Senate Print 5556 by Senator Palumbo, an act to amend the general municipal law. Senate Print 5603A by Senator May, an act to amend Part A-4 of Chapter 58 of the laws of 2006. Senate Print 5981 by Senator Myrie, an act to repeal Subdivision 2 of Section 189 of the Correction Law. Senate Print 6018A by Senator Harkum, an act to amend Chapter 63 of the laws of 2021. Senate Print 6054 by Senator Lanza, an act to amend Chapter 759 of the laws of 1973. Senate Print 6074 by Senator Salazar, an act to amend the Family Court Act. Senate Print 6336 by Senator Gallivan, an act in relation to granting Blake Russell additional service credit with the New York State and local police retirement system. Senate Print 6357 by Senator Savino, an act to amend the Family Court Act and the Social Services Law. Senate Print 6430 by Senator Steck, an act to amend Chapter 327 of the laws of 2006. Senate Print 6483 by Senator Gonardes, an act to amend the General Municipal Law and the Retirement and Social Security Law. Senate Print 6487 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the Real Property Tax Law. Senate Print 6510 by Senator Mannion, an act to amend the Environmental Conservation Law. Senate Print 6572 by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the Social Services Law. Senate Print 6619A by Senator Gonardes, an act to amend the Retirement and Social Security Law. Senate Print 6642A by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the Executive Law. Senate Print 6671 by Senator O'Mara, an act in relation to legalizing, validating, ratifying, and confirming certain transportation contracts. Senate Print 6686 by Senator Brook, an act to amend Section 4 of Part M of Chapter 56 of the laws of 2012. Senate Print 6703 by Senator Raff, an act to amend the Not-for-Profit Corporation Law. Senate Print 6767 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the Public Health Law. Senate Print 6768 by Senator Giannaris, an act to amend the Labor Law. Senate Print 6779 by Senator Mannion, an act to amend Chapter 448 of the laws of 2017. Senate Print 6783 by Senator Cooney, an act to amend the Education Law. Senate Print 6797 by Senator Stuart Cousins, an act to amend the Tax Law and Chapter 535 of the laws of 1987. Senate Print 6801 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend Chapter 451 of the laws of 2007. Senate Print 6818 by Senator Serrano, an act to amend Chapter 192 of the laws of 2011. Senate Print 6826 by Senator Ryan, an act to amend Chapter 122 of the laws of 2000. Senate Print 6832 by Senator Addabbo, an act to amend Part 1 of Chapter 61 of the laws of 2017. Senate Print 6890 by Senator Martucci, an act authorizing the conveyance of real property at the State University of New York College at Delhi. Senate Print 6896 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend Chapter 2 of the laws of 1998. Senate Print 6917 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the Private Housing Finance Law. Senate Print 6951 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend Chapter 514 of the laws of 1983. Senate Print 6964A by Senator Biagi, an act to amend the Executive Law. Senate Print 6975 by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the Private Housing Finance Law. Senate Print 7007 by Senator Fassad, an act to amend the Social Services Law. Senate Print 7008 by Senator Benjamin, an act to amend the Social Services Law. All bills report direct to third reading.
Move to accept the report of the Rules Committee.
All those in favor of accepting the Rules Committee report signify by saying aye. Opposed, nay. The Rules Committee report is accepted. Senator Giannaris.
Please take up the reading of the calendar.
The Secretary will read.
Calendar number 101, Assembly number 4319 by Assembly Member Dinowitz, an act to amend the Criminal Procedure Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 125, Senate Print 123 by Senator Kaplan, an act to amend the Executive Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 220, Senate Print 498A by Senator Bruzzin, an act to amend the insurance law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 338, Senate, Assembly number 7290 by Assemblymember Engelbrecht, an act to amend the environmental conservation law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 381, Senate Print 210B by Senator Fassad, an act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 100th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 406, Senate Print 523A by Senator Hoyerman, an act to amend the civil practice law and rules.
Read the last section.
Section 10, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 412, Senate Print 3262A by Senator Comrie, an act directing the Metropolitan Transportation Authority to study the feasibility of co-mingling public transit.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 62.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 438, Senate Print 412A by Senator Biagi, an act to amend the mental hygiene law and the racing, paramutual wagering, and breeding law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 443, Senate Print 1343B by Senator Brooks, an act relating to the acquisition of real property by eminent domain.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 443, voted in the negative, Senator Helming, ayes 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 528, Senate Print 4777A by Senator Mannion, an act to amend the general construction law.
Read the last section.
Section 27, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Mannion to explain his vote.
Thank you, Madam President. As of May 24, 2021, there are still sections of New York state law that use language that infers that people with mental disabilities are somehow inferior. This is a notion that all senators and all New Yorkers should completely reject. Today, the Senate is rejecting the use of the following words in our laws: lunatic, lunacy, and idiocy. While this may seem a small and symbolic gesture to some, I believe it's a massive step forward in recognizing the contributions of all New Yorkers. We know from the science and research that mental health is your physical health, and mental illness is a physical illness that requires medical intervention and treatment. If you're suffering from a medical condition, you are not a lunatic or an idiot or inferior. If you are disabled, you are not a lunatic or an idiot or inferior. This language needed to go a long time ago. Madam President, this year the Senate established a new committee dedicated to protecting and supporting disabled New Yorkers. Today we send a powerful message, but it also comes with a moral obligation to deliver real and lasting change for individuals, families, caregivers, and stakeholders. Under the leadership of Andrea Stewart Cousins, the State Senate is meeting these obligations. We are improving the lives of disabled New Yorkers in ways large and small, continuing the Senate's renewed commitment to the IDD community. I never want to let the disabilities community down. Ensuring we have the policies, funding, and proper supports in place to facilitate meaningful and productive lives for all IDD New Yorkers is one of my guideposts. I proudly cast my vote in the affirmative, and I am proud to sponsor this legislation. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Mannion to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 564, Senate Print 5010 by Senator Reichlin Melnick, an act to amend the real property tax law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 623, Senate Print 4350A by Senator Gunardes. An act relating to establishing the Angelina Liu as a genetic child and distributee of Wing Zhang Liu.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 639, Assembly number 6155A by Assemblymember Magnarelli. An act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 664, Senate Print 4085A by Senator Hinchey. An act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator Hinchey to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President. Healthcare, especially in our more rural communities, depends on our first responders, especially in districts like mine, with some counties that don't even have a hospital. In a medical emergency that requires air transport, access to a blood transfusion can mean the difference between life and death, again, especially for residents in our more rural and upstate communities, where the nearest trauma center may be hours away. New York is currently the only state in the country that does not allow medical helicopters to carry and transfuse blood, despite the fact that our air ambulance crews are trained to perform this life-saving care. This bill finally reverses this outdated and dangerous statute and gives our first responders the tools they need to continue to save lives across our state. And in the district I represent, it will ensure that every New Yorker gets the immediate medical attention and care that they need and deserve. Whether you're a farmer, a hiker, or traveling along our country roads, this bill could save your life, and it has never been more important. I am proud to sponsor this bill, and for that reason, I vote aye.
Senator Hinchey to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Akshar to explain his vote.
Madam President, thank you very much. Today is certainly a bittersweet day for a constituent of mine back at home. I want to tell a very quick story of Travis Flanagan, 30-year-old father of two. He is the husband to Lindsay, the father to Dylan and Madeline. Lindsay is pregnant with their third child. On March 13th, Travis was working in a cornfield, and the machine that he was operating had a mechanical issue. He got off the tractor, he went to try and address that mechanical issue, and with his leg, he was pushing on some corn stalks, and that machine then sucked the lower portion of his body into the machine. Travis, with his legs caught in this machine, laid in that field for more than 45 minutes screaming for help until his father, Mike, came and tried to help. Travis, because his father was so distraught, called 911 himself and asked the dispatcher to ensure that they sent a four-wheel drive vehicle because he was in the middle of a cornfield, but also asked them to send a medical helicopter. And I think much to everyone's surprise, in the state of New York, that medical helicopter couldn't, in fact, transfuse blood. And Travis knew that he had been bleeding so bad for 45 minutes that he needed a blood transfusion. And by the grace of God, a New York helicopter was not available. And they sent Guthrie Air from Pennsylvania to help Travis. And Travis attributes that blood transfusion with the fact that he is still here today. Had he not gotten that transfusion from the medics on that helicopter, he recognized and understood that he probably wouldn't be here with us today. Ken Whitmore is the fire chief in Smithville Flats. He said, in my 20 years of service, it was the worst call that I've ever been on. When I spoke to Travis about this particular issue and learned about his accident, he said to me, Fred, I still have both of my arms. I'm still able to hug my children. I'm still able to hug my wife. Use my tragedy so that we can save lives in the state of New York. Just as I close, I want to thank a couple of people. I want to thank the Farm Bureau. I want to thank the Association of Counties for their support of this particular bill. I want to thank a very close friend of mine back in my district, Judy Whitaker, who has been a strong advocate of this particular issue for us. But I especially want to thank the sponsor for her fierce advocacy on this issue. I want to thank Senator Rivera for his willingness to listen as the chairman on the Health Committee. When I called Senator Hinchey and explained Travis's plight, we discussed about how busy we are in Albany and all the things that we have to do, especially towards the end of session. Same conversation with Senator Rivera. But to a person, both of them were committed to moving this bill as quickly and as expeditiously as we possibly could through this House. So this is the way government is supposed to work. It doesn't much matter if you're a Republican or a Democrat. This particular bill will, in fact, save lives. So, Senator Hinchey, on behalf of Travis and Lindsay and Dylan and Madeline, I really thank you. I truly do, from the bottom of my heart, because I know undoubtedly that the work that we have done here today will, in fact, save lives. Madam President, I very proudly vote aye.
Senator Akshar to be recorded in the affirmative. Senator Obaraka to explain his vote.
Thank you, Madam President. I remember it like it was yesterday. It was a cool fall morning. It was October 4th, 2018. I remember it because it was my 32nd wedding anniversary. I walked into my kitchen and my scanner went off, as we would say in our service, the tones were dropped for an accident. What came across the scanner was catastrophic farm accident, 25-year-old male, and it gave the name of the farm. At that point, I knew it was my son. I call his cell phone. I don't get an answer. I call a friend of his who he worked with. I got his cell phone. I said, "Is it Derek?" He said, "Yes, it is." I said, "Is it bad?" He said, "Yes, it is." And I literally then took the father part of my brain and had to go to my emergency services side, and I actually started to triage this over the phone. As I'm listening to the tones continually drop to get an ambulance out to the site, I'm also saying that we need to get an air ambulance up in the air in case that was needed, knowing full well that in this case, he would not be able to get a transfusion. Time seemed to kind of just drag on as I remember, you know, the incident. We were finally able to get an ambulance there. He was transported. I am absolutely proud and honored to say that he is fine, much to the grace of God. You know, in my short tenure here in the Senate, this is a bill that I think is just absolutely an amazing piece of legislation. I want to thank Senator Hinchey for bringing this together. You know, we mirror up in the lower half of my district and with hers. More importantly, we mirror up in our conviction for those that are in the agricultural realm. Had this been available, I have no doubt that I would have called for air service, and we wouldn't have had half of the amount of stress and anxiety that went in with my son. Again, Derek is doing well. In fact, he is continuing to be the most ever pleasant pain for a child I've ever had. So I want to thank everybody, you know, for that. And it is my extreme honor and my extreme pleasure to vote in the affirmative. Thank you, Madam President.
Senator Obaraka to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 701, Assembly number 6158A by Assemblymember Wallace. An act to amend Chapter 698 of the laws of 1991.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 704, Senate Print 5666 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 704, voted in the negative, Senator Lanza, ayes 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 708, Senate Print 3959A by Senator Kennedy, an act to amend the public authorities law.
Read the last section.
Section 9, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 708, voted in the negative, Senator Helming, ayes 62, nays 1.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 709, Senate Print 4299A by Senator Lanza, an act to amend the vehicle and traffic law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 713, Senate Print 6091A by Senator Gallivan, an act to amend the highway law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed. There's a substitution at the desk. The secretary will read.
Senator Mannion moves to discharge from the Committee on Finance Assembly Bill Number 1153A and substitute it for the identical Senate Bill 1766A, third reading calendar 719.
Substitution so ordered. The secretary will read.
Calendar number 719, Assembly Number 1153A by Assemblymember Buttonshin, an act to amend the mental hygiene law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 722, Assembly Number 4572 by Assemblymember Godfrey, an act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 180th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 742, Senate Print 5581A by Assemblymember, by Senator Breslin, an act to amend Chapter 589 of the laws of 2015.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed. Calendar 758 is high and will be laid aside for the day.
Calendar number 780, Senate Print 1363 by Senator Serrano, an act to create a temporary state commission to study and make recommendations concerning the incidence of asthma.
Read the last section.
Section 6, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 781, Senate Print 1409 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the public health law.
Laid aside.
Calendar number 789, Senate Print 5438 by Senator Hinchey, an act to amend the alcoholic beverage control law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 808, Senate Print 6195 by Senator Passard, an act to amend the social services law.
Read the last section.
Section 10, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 809, Senate Print 1035A by Senator Addabbo, an act to amend the public health law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 812, Senate Print 4998 by Senator Mannion, an act to require the Office for People with Developmental Disabilities to establish the CARE demonstration program.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 815, Senate Print 1104 by Senator Stewart Cousins, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 90th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janoris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Aye, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 816, Senate Print 3920 by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes, 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 817, Senate Print 4485A by Senator Harkham, an act to amend the private housing finance law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Those senators voted in the negative are Senators Borello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 44, nays 19.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 830, Senate Print 975 by Senator Gorin, an act to amend the labor law.
Read the last section.
Section 2. This act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 830, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 43, nays 20.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 856, Senate Print 5346 by Senator Steck, an act to amend the general municipal law.
Read the last section.
Section 2. This act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 871, Senate Print 557 by Senator May, an act to amend the election law.
Read the last section.
Section 2. This act shall take effect on the 1st of January.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Senator May to explain her vote.
Thank you, Madam President. In the 2 years since early voting has been a thing in New York State, we've seen people flock to the polls for early voting. We've seen New Yorkers of all walks of life, young and old, upstate and downstate, urban and rural, Democratic, Republican, and other. We've also seen with the electronic poll books that it has worked extremely smoothly at sites all across the state. Now we have the opportunity to bring early voting to more New Yorkers with pop-up polling sites for 3 days. They could set up at the mall on the weekend or set up at a community college on weekdays and make voting accessible to more New Yorkers. So I'm excited that we have been able to bring this bill forward. I'm grateful to the leadership and my colleagues, and I proudly vote aye.
Senator May to be recorded in the affirmative. Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 871, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borello, Boyle, Griffo, Helming, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Ritchie, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 45, nays 18.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 895, Senate Print 552 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the education law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 913, Senate Print 5557 by Senator Mayer, an act to amend the retirement and Social Security law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect on the 60th day after it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Pruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 926, Senate Print 6410 by Senator Kennedy, enactment chapter 108 of the laws of 2016.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 954, Senate Print 6046B by Senator Harkum, an act to authorize the town of Newcastle, County of Westchester, to alienate and discontinue the use of certain parklands.
There's a home rule message at the desk. Read the last section.
Section 7, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 973, Senate Print 1093A by Senator Gorin, enactment of the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 973, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Boyle and Brisport, ayes 61, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 983, Assembly number 5605 by Assemblymember Epstein, enactment of the Environmental Conservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action takes effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 998, Senate Print 271 by Senator Myrie, enactment of the Real Property Actions and Proceedings Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this action take effect on the 120th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to count of 998, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Palumbo, Rath, Serino, Steck, Tedisco, and White, ayes 44, nays 19.
The bill is passed. There's a substitution at the desk. The secretary will read.
Senator Skoufis moves to discharge from the Committee on Finance Assembly Bill number 3130 and substituted for the identical Senate Bill 1836, third reading calendar 1010.
Substitution so ordered. The secretary will read.
Calendar number 1010, Assembly number 3130 by Assemblymember Steck, enactment of the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1011, Senate Print 3852 by Senator Serino, an act to amend the executive law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1015, Senate Print 4859 by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the retirement and Social Security law.
Read the last section.
Section 5, this act shall take effect January 1st, 2022.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1028, Senate Print 4221 by Senator Stavisky, an act to amend the Business Corporation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 14, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1028, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Lanza and White, ayes 61, nays 2.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1042, Senate Print 1405 by Senator Serrano, an act to amend the Parks, Recreation, and Historic Preservation Law.
Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1056, Senate Print 5800 by Senator Comrie, an act to amend the election law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect on the 180th day after shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Janaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1056, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borrello, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Ritchie, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 49, nays 14.
The bill is passed.
Calendar number 1058, Senate Print 607A by Senator Benjamin, an act to amend the public authorities law.
Laid aside.
Calendar number 1064, Senate Print 4715A by Senator Tedisco, an act to amend the village law and the public officers law.
Read the last section.
Section 3, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Adabo, Gianaris, Kruger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed. Senator Gianaris, that completes the reading of today's calendar.
Can we now move to the controversial calendar, please?
The secretary will ring the bell. The secretary will read.
Calendar number 781, Senate Print 1409 by Senator Rivera, an act to amend the public health law.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Madam President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk. I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that Senator Martucci be recognized and heard.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Upon review of the amendment in accordance with Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule it non-germane and out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Madam President, I appeal the ruling of the Chair and ask that Senator Martucci be recognized.
The appeal has been made and recognized, and Senator Martucci may be heard.
Madam President, I rise to appeal the ruling of the Chair. The proposed amendment is germane to the bill in front of the House because the bill in front of the House amends public health law. And for more than a year now, our governor has been using executive orders to amend New York's public health law. Frankly, Madam President, it's sad that we're here today still discussing arbitrary orders from Governor Cuomo. As many of my colleagues on this side of the aisle have pointed out, and I will once again today, we wouldn't be here if the majority had done a straight repeal of the governor's powers rather than the sham repeal that was brought to the floor here months ago. If a real repeal had been passed, we wouldn't be having this conversation today. In fact, the reason we're having this conversation today exposes that bill was nothing more than a fraud to our public. If anyone here has a two-year-old toddler, you'll know what I'm talking about. I'm the proud father of a five-year-old, a four-year-old, and an 18-month-old. So I've been through this, and I know a lot about two-year-olds. And what's clear to me is the governor's latest order that requires two-year-olds to wear masks at summer camps and in daycare was written by someone who has no clue what it's like to care for a two-year-old. This is utterly nonsensical and an unreasonable demand that's made on our child care providers and parents who've already had a tremendously hard job this year and continue to struggle. Now, our child care providers and our camps and so many others are going to spend tremendous portions of their day fighting to put masks back on little kids who already have a very, very low risk to begin with. Worse is that this policy contradicts one that the Office of Children and Family Services right here in New York announced last June on June 26th. That policy recommended but did not require masks to be worn by children in daycare and day camp settings. That's very interesting to me because what's happened since that June 26th order? Well, providers and employers have been vaccinated, parents and caregivers have been vaccinated, and infection rates are steadily on the decline. We got the latest infection rates from the governor just today in a press conference that he held talking about just how low they are. Large entertainment venues, restaurants, amusement parks, and everything else is reopened. The CDC has rescinded mask mandates for vaccinated individuals. And finally, after some pressure, our governor has accepted those standards. In short, things are way better than they were on last June 26th when that order was originally issued. And I remind you that masks were not required for children in child care settings back then in June. Why would Governor Cuomo choose now to mandate masks on our toddlers? It makes absolutely no sense, Madam President. It's not about public health, it's about control. And why would this body give this type of control to someone like our governor, who's under investigation from every form, for every form of corruption and by every imaginable law enforcement source? Last week, in fact, When our governor was asked at a press conference about the outrage people feel about him taking $5 million payment for writing a book about the pandemic that killed 50,000 New Yorkers, his reply was, quote, "That's stupid. Next question." Well, when someone asks me about this mask mandate for two-year-olds, my reply is the same. That's stupid. Next question. For these reasons, Madam President, I strongly urge you to reconsider the ruling, and I urge my colleagues to support this common sense amendment. Our kids are counting on us. Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you, Senator Martucci. I want to remind the House that a vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
Show of hands.
Madam President, we've agreed to waive the showing of hands and record each member of the minority in the affirmative.
Without objection, so ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 20.
The ruling of the chair stands and the bill in chief is before the House. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing and hearing none, debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act shall take effect immediately.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
Ayes 63.
The bill is passed. The secretary will read.
Calendar number 1058, Senate Print 607A by Senator Benjamin, an act to amend the public authorities law.
Senator Lanza, why do you rise?
Madam President, I believe there's an amendment at the desk. I waive the reading of that amendment and ask that Senator Griffo be recognized and heard.
Thank you, Senator Lanza. Upon review of the amendment, in accordance with Rule 6, Section 4B, I rule it non-germane and out of order at this time.
Accordingly, Madam President, I appeal the ruling of the chair and ask that Senator Griffo be recognized.
The appeal has been made and recognized, and Senator Griffo may be heard.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I believe that the amendment before the House is germane as it deals with the subject at hand of anti-bias and human rights. For over 2,000 years, the Jewish people have been the targets of hatred. The horrors and tragedy that history has shown us over the last century show how we must condemn this anti-Semitic behavior. It must be denounced, confronted, and combated. Sadly, we continue to see anti-Semitic threats, attacks, and vandalism, not only here in New York State, but across our country and throughout the world. Just recently, the New York City Police Department's Hate Crime Task Force is investigating a Jewish man reportedly assaulted in Times Square. At the same time, in Los Angeles, police are investigating several Jewish people simply dining at a restaurant who had bottles thrown at them. Synagogues in Arizona, Illinois, and New York have been vandalized. We've seen this increase significantly in just recent weeks. The Anti-Defamation League, a Jewish civil rights group, received over 193 reports of anti-Semitic incidents in just last week. And between May 7th and the 14th of May, there were 17,000 tweets that used a variation of the phrase, "Hitler was right." These deplorable threats and actions that we continue to witness are reprehensible, they're unacceptable, they're inexcusable, and they continue to spread fear throughout the Jewish community. Those who commit such acts should be held accountable for their actions. The human rights statute that we have in our state prohibits discrimination of New Yorkers for the purposes of age, race, color, creed, national origin, sex, gender identity, sexual orientation, marital status, military status, and disability. This amendment would ensure that we have additional provisions that we can protect those, particularly the Jewish faith, by codification and by clarification of terminology. It would ensure that all who participate in anti-Semitic acts, activities, or attacks of any type will face real and significant consequences for their action. These acts have no place, anytime, or anywhere. And I believe that this issue and the amendment accordingly are germane based on the discussion of human rights before us. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Thank you, Senator Griffo. I want to remind the House that the vote is on the procedures of the House and the ruling of the chair. Those in favor of overruling the chair signify by saying aye.
Request a show of hands.
Madam President, we have again agreed to waive the showing of hands and record each member of the minority in the affirmative. Thank you,
Senator. Without objection, so ordered. Announce the results.
Ayes 20.
The ruling of the chair stands and the bill in chief is before the House. The secretary will ring. Are there any other senators wishing to be heard? Seeing, hearing none, debate is closed. The secretary will ring the bell. The secretary will read. Read the last section.
Section 2, this act will take effect on the 60th day and it shall become a law.
Call the roll.
Addabbo, Giannaris, Krueger, Ort, Stewart, Cousins, White.
Announce the results.
In relation to calendar 1058, those senators voted in the negative are Senators Akshar, Borello, Boyle, Gallivan, Griffo, Helming, Jordan, Lanza, Martucci, Matera, Oberacker, O'Mara, Ort, Rath, Ritchie, Steck, Tedisco, and White. Ayes 45, nays 18.
The bill is passed. Senator Giannaris, that completes the reading of the controversial calendar.
Thank you, Madam President. Is there any further business at the desk?
There is no further business at the desk.
I move to adjourn until tomorrow, Tuesday, May 25th at 3 p.m.
On motion, the Senate stands adjourned until Tuesday, May 25th at 3 p.m.